business as we see around. Like the one I just saw on YouTube the other day, one man who says he's an apostle, saying that when he speaks in tongues, he generates money. And that the COVID, this coronavirus that shut down everybody in the last 1 year, he's been prospering. And people were shouting and praising and saying hallelujah. I say, which hallelujah to who? You mean to the devil? And people stood there and cheered. Because remember our last, some of the, we said in about 4 weeks or 5 weeks ago, I think it's all about 7 weeks, we said, you become who you believe. When you go in such gathering and believe such foolishness, such stupidity, tell me. I know many of you are hypnotized. I understand. I passed through that. Remember, that's why I shared my testimony last week. But as you are hearing my voice, that hold he or she has on you should be broken. The whole false teachers and pastors have on you should be broken. That's why we are teaching. Because when you know the truth sets you free. Tell me how thousands, hundreds of thousands are in that person's church, and that goes for many of them, giving him money to buy jets. And he's telling people that the virus that kept many people, killed over 3 million people in the world, that it is a very good thing because he's prospering. Is he speaking for God? No, he's speaking for the devil. It is time believers wake up from their slumber. If you are not going to speak the truth, who will speak the truth? Is God going to come from heaven to speak the truth? God has given us the truth to speak to our generation. God has given us the truth to break holds of that our people are in bondage. God has given you and I the mandate to free the captives with the message of the gospel. But instead, you will go in there and say, hallelujah, shall praise the Lord. No, you are not praising God. You are praising mammon. You are praising demons. Who is directing the business of your church organizations? Because if your church is being directed by the Holy Spirit, these men and women of the belly cannot be living such, having such lavish lifestyles, and people are still remaining there. If the answer is the Holy Spirit, then you know about spirit baptism. Because they would have told you about spirit baptism. And you will know that what we speak is truth. Because all our teachings are anchored on the Bible. So, if you have heard about Holy Spirit baptism in the church you attend, meaning they are speaking about it and praying for people to receive Spirit baptism and you have not received, then we have to ask, why haven't you received Spirit baptism? Is it that you don't have faith? You don't trust the gift? Is it that you don't know really the value of Spirit baptism? Or is it that you weren't taught in your denomination or church organization? If you were not taught, now you know. Do you belong to those church organizations that teach that spirit baptism has ceased? Should you still be in that church organization knowing what you know now? That cessationism is a false doctrine. That is that spirit baptism has ceased. Or that gifts of the Spirit have ceased with the death of the apostles. Should you be in such organization? Why are you there? If you have been following our series, you know that you cannot run and win the race to eternal life unless you are led by the Holy Spirit. That's a certain definite statement. I cannot win the race to eternal life unless the Holy Spirit indwells me and directs my life. And you cannot win the rest of eternal life unless the Holy Spirit indwells you and directs your path. I want you to know, if there's nothing else you want to learn today, know that you need the Holy Spirit to guide your life. And that if you don't have the Holy Spirit indwelling you, you will make a mess of your salvation. Like I said, if your church organization teaches about spirit baptism and you have not received it, I want to advance some likely reasons why you haven't. You have not really desired it. You have not seen the need. But now you know the need, so desire it. Or you are still tied to the world and you love the things of the world. You are friends with the world. Yeah, the Bible says friendship with the world is enmity with God. James Epistle. Friendship with the world is enmity with God. So if you're an enemy of God, how can he give you this great gift? Or you are in sinful relationship with someone. Yeah, some of you, they that tell you can live with somebody, you're male or female. You have to live with other people. Yes, you are practicing till you become married. You are living in sin. How will the Holy Spirit come? So break off that relationship. You love your sins too much. Maybe there are some other things you are doing. You are cheating. You are lying. You are doing all sorts of things. And you are not willing to give them up because through that you are making some income. Well, banish your sins. You have taken them before Christ and your soul. And remember what he said? The soul that sinneth shall die. I say to them, cut the umbilical cord if you are still tied to the world. Stop making excuses. Cut it, you can. The unbeliever has nothing to offer you. The world has nothing to offer you that Christ has not given. Cut off the arm that ties you to that sin or sinful relationship. If it's a man promising you marriage, you have to entitle to sin. Cut it off. He's not ready for prime time. If it's a woman, the same thing. If you're a guy, cut it off. Repent if you're an unbeliever. There's no way you can receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit unless you have known the Lord Jesus Christ. But when you repent, even if you're an unbeliever, hearing my voice now, and embrace the cross anew, you can even receive the Holy Spirit baptism as I pray today. But if you're a child of God, I want you to believe that you can receive it today too as we pray. We'll continue this series until as many as possible who have not yet been spirit baptized receive the Holy Spirit baptism. Praise the Lord. I plead with you, my brothers and sisters, and those who become my brothers and sisters. Shun the world. It starts from the heart, and then the grace of God will come. Shun the world. Praise the Lord. Now we're going to sing a song. You will do the reading and singing. We are going to sing a song and then I will pray.
Oh, Savior's love for me.
Praise the Lord. We apologize for technology. Some things happened on our system and we got interrupted. But the important thing, please, you will watch the broadcast and we're going to pray now. And as I pray, if you believe, you can still receive spirit baptism. Shall we pray? In Jesus' name we pray. Our Father and our God, we thank and bless you. We give you all the praise, all the glory and honor, for you are our God. Father, your children have heard your word today. The early church, the mark of those who have believed, was the spirit baptism. And throughout the time of your children in the early church, spirit baptism was emphasized. But the enemy came in and have deceived so many that they don't realize that they need spirit baptism to walk this walk. Father, I'm praying, oh Lord, have mercy. Even those who are in sin but who are your children, Lord, forgive them their sins this day, Lord. And let your spirit, Lord, empower them, because then they will understand they can no longer live in sin. Empower them, my Father, my God. Break every yoke. Break everything for those who have been hypnotized by their leaders, who hear things that are so stupid and still believe because they are hypnotized. You delivered me and mine years ago. Deliver them, Lord, so that they can flee from those places, from the mammon worshiping centers, and from the children of the devil, unless they repent, because they cannot continue spinning lies. Oh, Rishandara Kuri Masanda Bakandara Bakuri Marabasanda. Resetere Koshere Baba Bakuri Marababa Sende. Rishanta Sente Sarkachim Baba Kumba. Resetere Ribarabasere Mahurima. Sekesere Basenda Singo Kumba. Setere Barama. Rikasanda. Riboro Sende. Karama Kumba. Father, nullify. Put down those wicked ministries, Lord. Put them down, my Father, my God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And free your children. And as many as believe today, Lord, may they receive. May they receive in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And those who have received demonic tongues through these false leaders, Father, Lord, nullify and bring the Holy Spirit, empower them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, dear Father in heaven. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'll see you people next week.